it's Kyle here. I want to talk about some movies I want to see this summer. Going into 2013, there were quite a few movies. You know, I really wasn't, I just say, giddy to see this year. However, though, one movie in particular that I'm just dying to see in the next 2 weeks, Iron Man 3. I think it's supposed to be the last Iron Man movie, is what I heard. It's supposed to be the last Iron Man movie. I doubt it, but this is the next Iron Man movie with the Mandarin, Iron Man's greatest foe. So this is going to be awesome to see that character on screen. One thing that's cool about this movie, though, is that it's going to be kind of like serve two purposes. Because one, not only is it the third Iron Man movie, but this movie also... It's going to be a cliffhanger and lead you directly to the sequel of Avengers. So I thought that's pretty cool. You know, like I said, you're getting like a two for one thing with Iron Man 3, because like the ramifications of this movie is what sets the stage and the story for Avengers 2. So I thought that's cool how that's all going to tie in together. So definitely want to see that. Definitely want to see Star Trek, which also comes out on the 17th of May. Star Trek Into the Darkness. Forgot the director's name who directed that movie, but he's done with Star Trek. He's going on to move on to make the new Star Wars movie, Episode 7. So that's cool. But definitely want to see Star Trek, the first one coming out in 2009. I thought it was a really good, solid movie. Surprised it took them this long. I had wondered if they were going to come with a sequel at all, because I thought the movie was good. It did good at the box office, but we finally have a sequel to what I thought was a solid Star Trek movie or reboot to the franchise. So looking forward to that. There's also another movie I want to see called The Heat. It's a comedy movie coming out this summer, starring Sandra Bullock and Melissa McCarthy. For those of you may not know, Melissa McCarthy co-starred in the movie that came out earlier this year called Identity Thief. You know, fat lady, you know, comedic lady. I think she's hilarious. To me, she reminds me of a bit of a Chris Farley, kind of like a comedian, a female version of Chris Farley, which I really see a lot in her, which reminds me of her and just reminds me of Chris Farley. And a little bit of John Candy, too. Some of her comedic jokes, the way she does things, kind of like John Candy. So The Heat is a movie that's about Sandra Bullock, who's a cop. She does everything by the books, and you know, just like I said, just a strict, you know, chief police, does things by the books. And she teams up with Melissa McCarthy, who plays a cop, but a cop that kind of goes by her own rules. You know, she goes against what regular cops are supposed to do and what's standard for a cop to do, and kind of does her own thing and makes her own laws and whatnot. So that's going to be funny. So you can check it out on YouTube or something. It's called The Heat. So that looks funny. Definitely want to check that out. Another movie I'm also interested in seeing too is... mine's going blank here. The Hunger Games. The Hunger Games 2. Definitely looking forward to seeing this year. I thought the first one was a really good movie. And especially coming from someone who's never been aware or... gotten into the Hunger Game franchise via the book, because I've never read the books before. So like I said, so for me having no knowledge of the main plot, the story, and the characters, you know, like I said, based off the book from having never read them, I thought the movie was really, really good, and I became a fan of the movie because I thought it was just really well done. So I'm definitely looking forward to the Hunger Games 2. Definitely looking forward to that. Another movie I'm looking forward to, this is coming out this summer, later this year, Monsters, Inc. University. That's cool. Looking forward to that. Let's see some other movies I'm trying to think of. The last movie I definitely want to see, The Man of Steel. I'm not going to go into detail to talk about The Man of Steel in this video, because I made a separate video to talk about my thoughts on The Man of Steel, because I just thought it deserved it. But a video of its own to talk about it. So The Man of Steel is also another movie I want to see, which is out June 17th. Oh, also Fast and Furious 6. That's another movie I definitely want to see as well. I know a lot of people kind of get tired of the Fast and Furious series. Others who are loyal diehard fans of the series say that, you know, hey, it used to be about, you know, fast cars and hot women, and now they're kind of taking the Fast and Furious series and they're kind of turning it more into an action-packed blockbuster movie. Some Fast and Furious fans kind of have a problem with this. Me, I see no problem with it at all. I'm comfortable with it because I think if you could say the Fast and Furious series, it's still profitable, but it has dwindled down. It's not as popular as it once was. So you can't say it's kind of run its course, but I do think they needed the change, because I think if they would have kept with the same, you know, C plus mediocre storyline, but the cool cars and hot chicks, it would have just it the series I don't think would have even lasted this long and having six installments. So I think they did need to kind of change it up a bit, where, you know, and kind of make it more into a blockbuster action movie. Still have the same things that made what Fast and Furious famous, which was the chicks and the tricked out cars. But yet, kind of, you know, changing the story up a bit and making it a little bit more, you know, like I said, an A-list blockbuster summer movie. So I think they need to change. And then too, you also have Vin Diesel and Rock, who are two, you know, action stars coming together. They did great in Fast Five, so if they're gonna come together again with Fast and Furious Six, I think this is gonna be another solid Fast and Furious movie. So, you guys give me your thoughts on these movies here. Are any of these movies you're looking forward to seeing? Or any other movie that I may not have mentioned or don't know of, or it's coming out later this year that you're also looking forward to seeing? Oh, that's coming out. Let me know your thoughts in the box below. Subscribe. Peace.